Hello everyone. In this video, I will introduce to you how to use the programming software for Innosilicon control board. The required materials and tools are described below. Innosilicon PSU. There are two control boards for different CPU models. One is XC7Z010, and the other is TZ6668. This is a burning board, which consists of a burning module and a USB cable. The TF card on the burning module is used to copy the firmware. Card reader, used to copy firmware to TF card. Jumper cap for shorting the powering unit of the control board. Multimeter for testing voltage. The control boards of the two types of CPUs need to short-circuit the different powering unit pin headers. The TZ6668 control board needs to short-circuit the 1.8 volts powering unit pin header. And the XC7Z010 control board needs to short-circuit the 3.3 volts powering unit pin header. The voltage of the powering unit can be measured with a multimeter. Here is the 3.3 volts powering unit pin header of the XC7Z010 control board. And this is the 1.8 volts powering unit pin header of the TZ6668 control board. Let's first demonstrate how the XC7Z010 control board finds the 3.3 volts powering unit pin header. First, use the PSU to power on the control board. And adjust the multimeter to the DC voltage gear. The black lead is connected to the negative pole, the red lead is connected to the pin header, and the 3.3 volts powering unit pin header can be found. Turn off the PSU. And then use the jumper cap to short it. Let's demonstrate how the TZ6668 control board finds the 1.8 volts powering unit pin header. First, use the PSU to power on the control board. And the multimeter uses the DC voltage gear. The black lead is connected to the negative pole, the red lead is connected to the pin header. You can find the 1.8 volts powering unit pin header. Then turn off the PSU. Since the 1.8 volts powering unit pin header has been short-circuited, when this control board is purchased, there is no need to use the jumper cap to short-circuit when programming the firmware. Now install the burning firmware. First demonstrate the TZ6668 control board. You need to copy the corresponding firmware to the TF card. Take out the TF card from the burning module, insert it into the card reader. Then insert the card reader into the computer. Format the TF card as FAT32 mode. And copy the corresponding burning files to the TF card. Then take out the TF card and insert it into the burning board. And insert the burning board into the control board according to the direction of the demonstration. Connect the USB cable. One end is connected to the burning board, and the other end is connected to the computer. The indicator light of the burning board is blue, indicating that there is no problem with the connection. Check whether the computer port settings are correct. It must be set to 115200 here. Connect PSU and control board. Open the serial port software. Notice, both MAC and type must be checked and filled in, and the MAC address can be obtained by the Innosilicon IP scanning software. The scanned control board model is T2, and the MAC address can be seen here. Enter the MAC address you just got, or copy it. Models can be directly selected. If there is no model we need here, we can enter it manually. Click Open Serial Port. Check Erase. Then click Erase Flash. Turn on the PSU to power on the control board. When we see that flash pass is displayed here, it means that the erasing is successful. Turn off the PSU and burning software, and then reopen the burning software. Attention, when burning the file, MAC and type should also be checked and filled in. The MAC address is still the same as the previous address. And type selects the model we want to burn. For example, we burn the T2T model. Click Open Serial Port. Then click Burn. Now power on the PSU again. When you see the operation time running, it means that the file is being burned. There is a burning details that can also be viewed here. When pass appears on the interface of the burning software, turn off the PSU, indicating that the burning of the file is successful. If OK is displayed at the status, it means that the control board has been programmed. Next, I will show you how to burn the XE7Z010 control board. First, take out the TF card and format it in FAT32 mode. Then copy the firmware to the TF card. Load the TF card into the test board. Connect the PSU and plug the test board into the control board in the directions shown in the demo. Connect the USB cable. One end is connected to the test board, and the other end is connected to the computer. Open the serial port software. Check MAC and type. Fill in the MAC address. And select T2 for type. Turn on the PSU. Then click Open Serial Port. Check Erase. And click Erase Flash. When Pass appears on the interface, the erasing is successful. Next, start burning the software. Close and reopen the burning software. Check MAC and type, and enter the MAC address and model T2T. Then turn on the PSU to supply power to the control board. Click Open Serial Port and Burn. When type T2T pass appears, it means that the file has been burned successfully. You can also check whether the burning is successful according to the burning details. Okay, the above is how to use the Innosilicon control board burning software. Thank you for viewing.